So I haven't made a YouTube video in actually 5 years, and this is why. I've been studying for the CPA exam.
Well, I haven't literally been studying every day for the past 5 years, but for the past year, I have been.
And now that I'm done and I've passed all 4 parts, I'd like to share my experience with the world and hopefully help someone going through the same thing, because these exams are terrible and I did not think I was going to make it. But I did, and I can share that now, and then maybe you can learn something from my experience. I sat for these exams while I was doing my master's program, so I have my undergraduate degree in accounting. I did a public accounting internship, and then I jumped into my master's program. And the company I did my internship with, I will be starting with them full-time later this year. They provided me with Becker, which is what I used to study, which I highly recommend. Becker is really good. If you use Becker, you can really prepare for these exams, which you could probably use any program, but I had Becker, and I highly recommend it. So I started studying in May of 2019, and I started with Reg. Here are all my notes for Reg. There are a lot of them. I am not a tax person. I do not enjoy tax. I don't like thinking about taxes. I dread filing my own taxes. Tax is not my thing. So I started with Reg because I wanted to get it done and over with. At the same time as I was studying for Reg using Becker, where I was taking these notes, I also was taking the grad tax class in my master's program. And I highly recommend trying to line up coursework with your exams if you're able to, because that overlap is really helpful. You're not splitting your brain. Oh, tax at school and at home when I'm studying. So I think that if you're able to do that, I highly recommend it. Combined, I did a lot of tax that summer. Not my favorite thing to do, but it worked because I passed Reg and I got an 85, and I'm very proud of that 85. Did not think I was gonna pass. Well, that's not true. They say, like, when you're leaving the exams, if you feel like you failed, you probably passed, and if you think you passed, you probably failed. I disagree with that. I think if you're well prepared for the exams and then you go and take them and you feel, oh, I was prepared for that, like, you were probably fine. You have to know yourself. When I left Reg, like, I thought I passed it, and I did. I think it's very dependent on the person, and you need to know, like, your test taking abilities. Like, I've always been really good in standardized tests, so I think that's why I wasn't concerned, and I know myself well enough to know. It's definitely very personal. And if you don't feel like that, like, that's okay. I don't know, we can just stop talking about it. I highly recommend making your own flashcards, because then you can narrow down on topics that you don't understand and really hammer them in. Like the like-kind exchanges, it's on the top because I did not get those. Like, there's multiple like-kind exchange note cards in here that say the same thing, just because I needed that repetition to remember. So I highly recommend doing that. Yeah, so I passed Reg, I took it in August. I accidentally almost scheduled for my birthday, and then I rescheduled that because that was not happening, but whatever. So my next exam was BC, or my note cards for BC, and my notes. There's less information in BC, but somehow there's still a ton of notes. It almost looks like the same amount. I think that's because BC is so random. It's like, here's internal control framework, here's economics, here's finance, here's ratios, here's corporate governance, here's cost accounting. Like, there's so much information, and it's all so random. It can be really tough. Like, people say BC is easy, and I disagree, because that exam is wild. Especially when I was taking it, because I took BEC my first real semester of grad school. Taking full-time classes, I was a TA for financial accounting, so like accounting 101 class. I was also helping tutor intermediate accounting, which is difficult. I was taking one of the most difficult graduate courses at UCF. So like, it was a lot. I had to reschedule BEC twice because I was not ready. The first time was free, and then the second time I rescheduled, I had to pay the $35, and that is the best $35 I spent last year because I passed BEC, got an 84, and I'm so grateful. I was originally gonna take it like early October, and then rescheduled it for November, and that extra month, I really needed it because I was not gonna pass. The day I took this test, I did not have a good day. I scheduled it for the afternoon because it was all I could get, and I am not a good afternoon test taker because I live far away from the testing center, and I ate breakfast, but I didn't eat lunch because I left my apartment at like 11, and I was like, I just ate breakfast. I don't need to eat anything else. Not true. I should have brought a snack or something, because by like 2 o'clock, I felt terrible. My head was hurting. Couldn't think straight. I'm so hungry. That's all I can think about, but I survived. It was wild. I'm glad I passed because BC is terrible. The B in BC stands for bad, because it's bad. But then after BEC, my next exam was everybody's favorite, FAR. The F in FAR stands for frickin' lots of information. So here's all my notes for that. They're separated by module. They're color-coded too. And then I also have flashcards, lots of them. I also carried these around everywhere with me. I would take them to restaurants. They were in my purse. Like, there's so many, they didn't even fit in the case all at the same time. It's a lot of flashcards. They're very helpful. The thing about FAR though, like, I did the best on FAR. I got a 94 on FAR, which is ridiculous. I think that's because of a few things. First of all, like I was saying earlier, I was a TA. So, like, I was teaching people the information I was getting tested on. That really helped. If you can get a TA position, highly recommend. Second of all, I had an extra month to study for FAR. I started studying for it in January. I was going to take it in April. But because of the Rona, I was unable to take my April exam because the parametric centers were closed. I was able to really slow down and study a lot. Probably too much, honestly. 94 is ridiculous. I'm glad I passed FAR because that was a beast of an exam. Which I said about BEC. They're beasts in a different way. BEC is just random. FAR is just so much information. I think my exam, I really lucked out. Some of the crazier topics, I didn't have a lot of on my test. Like, I didn't see a lot of leases. I don't remember seeing pensions. I remember having a lot of not-for-profit, which was good because I took a not-for-profit grad class that same semester. So again, with overlapping the coursework with the exam as much as possible. I really thought my sims were really good, which is weird because normally I think sims are bad, but those sims I thought were pretty fair and good and were very reasonable for an entry-level CPA. And that's what the CPA exam is for, is to prepare an entry-level CPA for being a CPA. I don't know, I don't want to get in trouble for like talking about what's on my exam, so I'm trying to be vague, but like, I really enjoyed, not enjoyed, but enjoyed. I thought my exam was very fair. I would have been pissed if I didn't pass that exam, because I was like, man, if I'm failing, like, who is passing? Because it's like, I basically studied for the exam for like 6 months because I TA'd and tutored in it and thought about it. So much information. So yeah, here's all my FAR stuff, all these note cards. If somebody wants these, leave a comment. I'll send them to you. Probably not, but if you want them. So lastly, we had audit. So audit's funny because there's only like 10 note cards here because I was so tired and burnt out. My grad program kicked my ass. I was so exhausted. And with everything moving to online in March, just craziness, by the time I got to audit, I was so tired. I spent so much time with my laptop. I spent so much time with Becker. I did not have the energy to make note cards. So I made like none. Like I made one for A5. Like that's ridiculous. Didn't really use them this time, but in normal circumstances, I recommend the note cards, but whatever. But I did take a ton of paper notes and I did a ton of practice exams for audit. Because audit is weird because it is all conceptual. Like there's like no math except for sampling, and the sampling math is weird, and just hope you don't get that on your exam because sampling makes no sense. Audit, I don't know. I really complained a lot while I was doing audit, but looking back, I think it's really cool the way that everything connects with audit, especially compared to BEC where everything is just a bunch of random crap. Like audit is very much all integrated and all makes sense together. Like while I was studying it, I was really struggling to put it all together, but by the time I was finished, it all clicked. All we care about is like, is there gonna be a material misstatement in the financial statements? Yes, all right, we care. No, who cares? Which makes sense, like if you've worked in audit, like I did for 3 months during my internship. But putting it all together for an exam, I think, is a lot different. Once it did all click, I just felt like a genius. Even though like, I did the worst on audit, I got an 81, which like isn't bad compared to the other exams. Like I obviously did a lot better with the other ones. Looking back, I don't mind audit. I still think BEC is the worst one. I passed all of them on my first try. It took me a year. Don't believe those people who are like, oh, you can do it in like 3 months. Yeah, that's possible, but cut yourself some slack. Like these exams are really hard. They took a lot out of me. BEC, I rescheduled a bunch of times because I was so overwhelmed with grad school and being a TA. My audit exam kept getting canceled and I had to keep rescheduling it because of the coronavirus. I had an appointment to take it in Savannah and I live in Central Florida, so that was gonna be ridiculous, but luckily I was able to take it in Florida. Like I was able to take it at my local testing center. The exam is normally crazy, but it was like extra crazy this year. It's definitely possible. That's what a good message. It's possible. No, these exams are crazy and they're really hard, but if you put in the time and the effort, they're passable. Like you can do it. And even if you do have to take more than one try, that's fine too. The most important thing is to pass it because of how many doors it can open up for you. Highly recommend CPA exam? No, if you are doing the CPA exam, like it's possible you can pass them. It's a lot of work, but it's worth it in the end, hopefully. I don't know, I just finished, so who knows, it'll pay off. I don't know, I don't have a good message for this video ending. So I hope me sharing my experience is helpful for you and you've learned something and maybe you feel less alone working through these exams because they're terrible. Everybody I know struggled with them. It's possible, you can do it, and I believe in you. Thank you for watching.